Oh my god.
Hi everyone.
Hi.
Oh my gosh, your dog is totally hamming it up. I love it.
Yes. Hey, wake up. Wake up.
Well, hello and welcome to a very special edition of MyApo Talks 2. This is the first ever edition of a talk show format of MyApo Talks 2. And today we'll be talking about how empowered women empower women. And joining me today are three dynamic personalities who also happen to be household names in Malaysia. They are none other than the National Director of Miss Universe Malaysia, Datin Elaine Daly, entrepreneur and actress Kavita Sidhu, and actress and producer Tong Bing Yi. Well, all three women are beautiful and they are former beauty queens, but they have since grown to be successful women in their own right. And if anyone knows that it takes more than a pretty face to do well and live a happy and meaningful life, it would be them. So this segment is brought to you by professional skincare brand Babor, with the hope that all women and anyone watching really will get a little bit of hope and inspiration and empowerment during this lockdown. So without further ado, let's dive right in. Ladies, thank you for being here today.
Thank you for having us.
It's really good to see all of you. And I want to kick off with the fact that we are in the middle of what seems like a never-ending lockdown. Yeah, I know, it's painful, but let's find out what each of you have been up to during the lockdown. What's a typical day like? Maybe you can start with Elaine.
My typical day for me, well, I have two little girls and they are very busy with their Zoom classes. So it's logging them on, sitting next to them, making sure that they don't run around like monkeys. Also, my husband and I, you know, we have an exercise schedule that we try to adhere to almost every day, on my spin bike, and, you know, lots of cooking, lots and lots of cooking. And basically that's it.
Cool. What about you, Pingyi?
Actually, life is getting busier this MCO, because from the last two experiences, from the MCO 1-2, so actually I decided not to waste the time for waiting. First of all, I have some group activities among my families. I try to make the dumpling. We break our records by making around 20 dumplings and sending over to all our friends and families. So that's a very good experience. So from the working side, actually, I'm quite relaxed because we can't do anything, especially producing the movie. So I'm just starting to do some preparations for the next two projects, which I should get started next year.
Fantastic, Pingyi. And Kavita, what about you?
So for me, you know, my husband has three restaurants. So he still has to go to work to his restaurants, which is really good for him because he needs to get out and do something, as we all feel that we want to still keep on working, right? So my schedule is, we try and throw in some exercise. So usually it's in the morning. If not, it's in the evening. And you know, our times now is so flexible that it doesn't really matter. I mean, we don't have children, you know, like Elaine. So in terms of like structuring our day according to their online class, so we don't have that. So it's more really focusing on our work. I do a lot of Zoom meetings as well, you know, preparing for our next project. We feel like we want to keep on moving forward and doing things because there's so much of uncertainty, especially now, like we can't plan, we're not sure when we're going to open up. So it really is keeping a positive mindset, you know. And I also have my mom, is an aging parent, so she lives very close by to me. So I do make the time to go and see her. I think that's really important as well as a family. We need to support each other so you don't feel that sense of isolation.
I hear some common threads. I hear things like family, right? Making dumplings with family, going to see your mom, looking after your two daughters, Elaine. I mean, there's a lot of family, I guess more cherishing of family as well during this pandemic. Any other big life lessons that you have learned throughout the pandemic?
One of the lessons that I've learned is to be resilient, you know, and I try and advocate that, you know, to the people on social media and all that, to tell them to be strong, because a lot of people are not going through, you know, the best of times. So being resilient, being strong, being, you know, being very mindful about what we do and what we say, you know, I think that's really important. And I think I've learned that, not to just mouth off, you know, and make sure that, you know, it's to be very careful, basically.
So I'm looking at all of you right now, and all of you look amazing. I have to ask, do you wake up looking like that every day?
Not at all.
Okay, please, you know, enlighten me, enlighten everyone watching as well. Do you wake up looking flawless, ready for the day, or what is it like behind the scenes?
No, I do not wake up looking like this or having makeup on my face, that is for sure. I'm only making an effort for you and the rest of the ladies, Victoria, and whoever else is watching this.
That's cool.
No, but you know, I think in all honesty, when we have time now, time to take care of ourselves. So, you know, I think taking care of your skin is very, very important. Yeah, so I don't wake up looking like this at all. But Kavita does, right, Kavita?
No, absolutely not.
I think she's the only one, right, Kavita?
No, my God. I don't, I mean, for sure, just like everyone else. But I think, you know, I think being natural is so beautiful anyway, right? And of course, I mean, we're doing a Zoom and it's on video and, you know, all of us in our industry and we're trained to know that we have to put a certain amount of makeup so you don't look pale, right? So these are the things. But for me, yeah, I mean, of course, when I'm not doing anything, there's absolutely no makeup and I love that. But I still do make an effort to try and look decent in a way because it's really important for me. I feel it makes me feel good. And so when my husband comes home, he's not going to see like, well, sometimes he does, but you know, generally, like I'm a little bit put together. That's all I'm saying. So that's, you know, we go for our grocery runs, we do things like that. So I feel good about myself if I just, you know, make a little bit of an effort, like, you know, make sure I shampoo my hair and, you know, it just, I feel good and I love wearing perfume, smelling good, you know, maybe just a little bit of powder on my face if, you know, if I'm going out to wherever, the groceries and stuff. So that's important. And, you know, I was excited this morning. I was like, oh my gosh, it's great. And I was actually telling him that in the bathroom. I said, Roberto, it feels so good to be putting on makeup, you know, wearing a nice top, right? Even I've got my proper pants. And doing this because you feel like you are moving forward, you feel alive.
Yeah.
You know, isn't it, Elaine? You don't
feel
absolutely. Like stuck in this pandemic right now with so much of uncertainty. So it's like, wow, that's empowering. You know, in a different way. But I think men as well, you know, even for women, I mean, even for my husband, I mean, he loves it. He's like putting on his shirt and he's off to the office. And that's where the mental mindset and mental health comes into play, right, Elaine, where you feel you are doing something useful. Gosh, I'm sound like I'm lecturing, but because it's so important to me. You know?
Go for it, Kavita.
Yeah. And you just feel hopeful. I think that's important. So, you know, there are a lot of women that just are such natural beauties anyway, just a little bit, something a little bit to make you feel better.
Just to perk you up, you know?
Yeah.
No, I think that's so well said. I'm curious to know now. So Kavita does a bit of like shampooing and perfume. Yeah. What is your maybe basic three things that you do to just feel normal and put together?
I think the basic stuff to make me feel comfort, I think, is sunblock. Yeah, I think sunblock is very important. Yeah, because and nowadays, we always like doing the Zoom meeting or everything. We're always facing the computer.
I just sunblock, I love it. That's all I need.
I just want to make sure that, okay, I'm done with my beauty routine. So then I will feel safe.
So good skincare at night and sunblock during the day. Mm. Cool. Elaine, what about you?
For me, it's, you know, good skincare in the morning and at night. You know, it's your cleansing and your moisturizing and the creams that make you feel good and smell nice. You know, I don't put on makeup, you know, but I have to put on a pair of earrings. That makes me feel like, okay, I'm ready to face the day. I know it's strange, right?
But I love it though.
My earrings.
I haven't worn earrings in forever.
It's fluffy, but you know, it's something that it's just, okay, I'm ready now. And my watch.
Accessories, okay.
Yeah.
I love how different everyone is, but there is a bit of a routine or just a few things to get us in the right headspace. Okay, so I know all of you don't wake up looking flawless every day. I feel comforted as a woman. Okay, I want to move on and ask. So we're talking about beauty routines and, you know, the love for creams and skincare. I understand that Babor sent each of you different products. Maybe you could show us a little bit of what you got and how you've been using it, and tell us how you have been finding it as well. Let's start with Elaine.
The extra firming cream, because, you know, as we age, of course, the skin is not as taut anymore. So, you know, the extra firming cream helps me to just, you know, for a little lift. I'm a big fan of eye creams and the extra firming serum as well. I think the eye cream has done wonders to my under eyes, because I always suffer from quite bad, eye bags.
I don't see anything right now.
It's called makeup.
So your favorite one out of the lot would be?
The eye cream, definitely. Okay. Yeah.
Cool. All right. Kavita, what about you?
I love the products, love Babur. I'm a skincare junkie. Like, I use so many different products. So what I got was the Pro Youth eye cream, and then the serum, also Pro Youth. It's called Pro Youth Reversive, and the face cream. I think this is a day cream, but I love it. Obviously, these are luxury products. I can tell. You can tell from the ingredients. You can tell from when you put it on your face. So yeah, I mean, I love the eye cream. Just like Elaine said, it's really great, and the face cream is good too, because it's quite light.
And favorite product would be the eye cream as well, or the eye serum?
I would say, yes, I mean, the eye cream for sure. I would say maybe the eye cream and serum. The serum's pretty good too. Yeah.
Nice. Pingyu, what about you?
I've got all the ampoules, different kind of ampoules from Babor, yes. Like a perfect glow for the hydration, stress control, the precious collections, minimal effort, maximum result, and everything. But I love it so much because, to be honest, I use a lot of different products. And okay, normally I seldom use ampoules because I never explore on ampoules. But this time I feel like ampoules really a lifesaver. It's not only a skincare product. You can have the immediate visible effect. I really like the texture, and it's very fast to absorb and the deep penetration. Maybe because of the molecule is small. So I really like the feeling, and I've tried the 7 days ampoules. So after the 7 days, you can immediately see the difference from before and after. Yeah, I really like it.
Wow. So interesting to hear all of your different experiences.
I started to fall in love with ampoules.
Wow.
Have all of you used ampoules as well, Elaine and Kavita?
Yes, I have.
Okay.
I'm also a beauty junkie.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Mostly during facials, I think, I've had ampoules put.
Yeah.
So it's great, yeah.
My goodness, the three of you. I have to say, right, I think a key thing that I'm picking up is that all three of you are very disciplined when it comes to skincare. Like, you don't actually just cleanse your face and go to sleep. You take time, you know, you care for your skin, you try out different products. That's really impressive. Just not at the very beginning, the whole thing about, you know, you need more than just a pretty face to go far in life. What do you think of that statement? And what do you think about the difference between prettiness and beauty? So someone who's pretty versus someone who's beautiful. What are your thoughts? And we could start with Pingyu, maybe?
Actually, pretty is having a good appearance, no doubt. So, but beauty is something shines from within. So I just think that as a woman, we have to be confident on ourselves and be expertise in our profession. So take up every challenge in your life and be brave and to confront every failure. Just accept the imperfection of ourselves.
Very, very good. Elaine, what about you?
Well, I think, being a huge part in the beauty industry, I think beauty is very, very subjective. What's pretty anyway? You know, a flower is pretty, you know, a dress is pretty. But beauty does come from within, as Pingyu said. It's a gift, actually. Beauty is a gift that, you know, each and every person has, you know, everybody has beauty in them. It just depends on the amount of beauty that you're willing to give out to other people.
And I think coming from your background as well, you've seen so many beauty queens over the years as, you know, National Director of Miss Universe Malaysia. And from country to country, prettiness does look very different.
Very different. Very different.
Kavita, what about you?
You know, I've always felt very strongly about this. I think we're all beautiful, and that's our God-given right. I think that society, unfortunately, has put, you know, the perfect idea of what beauty should look like. I mean, in some professions, that's like, if you're a model, I mean, you can, you know, have unique different looks, and that's beautiful in all different ways. But I think that when you talk about, of course, it's confidence and it's about having presence. So it doesn't matter what you look like, if you've got the perfect nose or the perfect shape of face or whatever it may be, it's your presence, you know, and it's how you show up. And that's real beauty. Anyone can do anything they want to in life and be just beautiful. And I wish more women would be able to hear that.
I hope every woman listening to this right now remembers that, because I think sometimes I think we're all naturally drawn to the outside first, but then what is sustainable, what is long lasting really goes beyond that. I want to hear, I mean, all three of you are confident women and it comes across, right? I love this conversation we're having. I love the insights being shared. Do you have a role model in terms of the values that you just brought up? So a woman that encompasses all that, like a role model of sorts that, you know, has kind of guided you over the years or that you look up to?
You know, I look at every woman out there and I think they're inspiring in their own special way. So for me, it's, you know, it's people like you who inspire me, you know. Not one particular person.
I love it. So you pick up different things from different women that you find beautiful.
Yeah.
That's so sweet. Thanks, Elaine. Bingyu, what about you?
I think my answer will be slightly different, because actually I admire many politicians since I was young. If I'm not an actress, so maybe I will be a politician.
Or you could be both.
No, just kidding. Okay, but I think I'll choose Michelle Obama, because I admire her wisdom and she has proven that there's no race, religion and color that stands out from the others.
Thank you, Ping Yi. And again, you can be a politician someday. We do need good people.
Okay.
Kavita, what about you?
I mean, for sure, Michelle Obama, definitely. I mean, she's incredible.
And go so crush, many women. Right?
Yeah. I mean, so many women, of course, that inspire us, right? For me, I would say it would be my mom, really. I think she, to me, is such an incredible role model. And no matter what, it does impact you. You know, I only realized this a few years ago of how much what she did at her time in the 70s, being a doctor and having to break those barriers without even realizing it. That was so empowering. And she actually paved the way, she, of course, and her team of women at that time, doctors, paved the way for the younger generation of women. And at that time, so that's inspiring to me. That's empowering. I think it's something that we still need to carry on doing. For women to have a better place, I think, in our workplace, in society. So women who do that inspire me. And I'm always surrounded by, I've noticed that even in my work, it's always women. You know, men are great as well, of course, but I work better with women and they inspire me. So my mom would be top of the list, I think, who sort of planted that seed in me.
What are some of your proudest accomplishments or achievements over the years?
There are quite a few things, I mean, for me personally, that I'm proud of. I mean, it dates back to when I was in school, always, you know, pushing myself. I was captain of my sports team in school, represented my district in high jump, always setting goals. And those, you cannot take away the value of those little accomplishments that you achieve when you were in school and then you move on to the next. And then I went to Paris to model, and I did that via compiling a book of my photographs and going to the agency in Singapore, because at that time it's not like you can just go onto the internet, and you know, you had to go through these different channels. And she was so blown away, and I was 17, she was like, wow, I've never seen a model come in here and open up your lookbook and have everything done professionally. And then she hooked me up, the agency in Paris. So you know, just doing those things at that age, 18, I mean, so many like milestones, I think.
Very cool. Bingyu, what about you? Tell us about some of your proudest accomplishments.
I think the proudest accomplishment for me recently I won the first Best Actress Award from Melbourne Indie Film Festival.
Oh, yay!
That was a huge surprise for me because I think nobody will believe that I can do that. Yeah, even if my family, I think they will be very surprised and very happy for that. So I think that is the proudest moment for every actor because I love my job, I love my role. So I'm so proud that being recognized in this industry that I've put efforts for more than a decade.
Congratulations,
Bing.
Thank you.
A decade of hard work. Congratulations. Elaine, what about you? Some of your proudest highlights, accomplishments over the years?
I mean, you know, as what Kavita is saying, you know, every step of the way is a different involvement. Probably when I was much younger, it was, you know, getting my law degree, getting called to the bar, never practicing because I love the arts industry way too much. And then, you know, winning Miss Malaysia, representing Malaysia in Panama, winning a Best Actress Award. I think, you know, all these things throughout the years when people said that I couldn't, especially when people said, you know, you sure you want to do this, or you sure you want to do that, are you sure you can take this role, or, you know, there will always be people coming up to you no matter what industry you're in, and you know, you try and prove them wrong and you work as hard as you can to make sure that, you know, you achieve whatever you want to achieve. But I think, you know, my biggest accomplishment to date is having my two kids. I think, you know, that can't be taken away from me at all. And it's such a wonderful feeling.
I want to keep asking you ladies questions and keep chatting because it's been so good. But I think maybe we should wrap up. And I want to ask, what are some simple and practical ways that you think women can start supporting other women? Because, you know, empowered women empower women.
When we see our fellow women kind, you know, we should always have good things to say about them, you know, give them compliments, have this energy inside of you that's going to go like, hi, how are you doing? Oh, you look great today, you know, that kind of thing, you know, that kind of simple things might make an impact in their lives. You know, you never know, because, you know, they're probably going through a terrible time right now, especially now. And they probably, you know, probably don't get compliments or, you know, don't get acknowledgements from whether it's their spouses or anybody.
Kavita, what about you?
There's a lot that we can do now, especially during this pandemic, to help other women. I mean, I'm part of quite a few WhatsApp women's groups, business groups, and even otherwise. And it's just fantastic. I mean, it's really about helping each other. How can we, you know, support each other in our business? Or if they're making food, you know, we order food from them, you know, yeah. How to help them online, right? You know, giving them a bit of exposure. I've kind of taken quite a few DMs, like I get from, you know, women, mostly actually women entrepreneurs. And I said, sure, I'll put it up for you, help. So we can help each other that way. And it's so important because men have it. It's, you know, the boys club is there. They help each other, and they're fine. It's wonderful, and I love being on this chat, these few chat groups. There's a certain feminine energy about it. You know, they're like, "Good morning, lovelies. How are you all today?" I mean, it's serious things like that actually you kind of feel you're part of the tribe.
Yeah.
And, you know, Elaine. So we don't want to ostracize women, and I think you know, cut out this, you know, competitiveness and this, you know, rubbish stuff that sometimes may go on between women. We need to come together and empower each other and support each other, I think. And it happens all the time. I see it, it's so beautiful.
Yeah. Bingyi, what about you?
I think women can support women in many ways, like reaching out your hand to them. Besides that, actually, I think women is quite sentimental. So sometimes I would rather be a good listener. I think they need it. Especially like my mom, because the pandemic time, actually many things happen in the family, you know, because you all always spend the time together. So sometimes she just keep mumbling and feeling like very negative, but I think that she just need a good listener. So I'll try to listen, be patient, to listen to what they want or what they really feel inside. So I'll try to solve the problem. If cannot, I just be a good listener and just a good companion for them.
That is so practical and sometimes very hard to do, because listening and, you know, again, holding our tongue isn't easy. Ladies, thank you so much. I really feel like I'm empowered from this session with the three of you. Really, thank you so much for sharing from your heart and sharing your beauty with us, not just, you know, refreshing the screen with your good looks. I feel inspired, and I hope every person watching as well feels the same way. So even during this lockdown, it is difficult. I think remember that you're not alone. There are women here from different walks of life, different experiences that hopefully has shed a little bit of light and inspiration for you. So to every woman watching, and to the men as well, if you're watching, thank you for spending your time with us. And once again, to Elaine, Kavita, and Bingri, thank you all for your time and your sharing. To everyone, take care, stay safe, and stay empowered.
Bye, everyone.
Bye. Bye.